herself. So why don't you introduce?
My name is Garima Goel. I have joined in FPM 2018 batch in Finance and Accounting area. So regarding my educational qualification, I have done my BCom honours from Sri Venkateshwara College, University of Delhi. My MCom in Finance from Delhi School of Economics, University of Delhi. Post which, I have worked as an assistant professor in a private university named MBA University in Faridabad for 18 months, and where I was taking subjects in Finance and Accounting area. So post which I started applying. Then to add one detail to it, I qualified my JRF in 2017. So that opened me the avenues for applying for PhD program.
So how come, who told you about this FPM program, or was you already aware about it?
Like few of my friends got in IIM Calcutta. So I had a fair idea about it. Mm-hmm. But in the process, my colleagues at university helped me out that you should explore PhD if you have qualified your JRF, mm-hmm. you have WorkEx. And in the meantime, I wrote one research paper, so that why didn't you support, why shouldn't I go for PhD if I want to get into teaching area.
So you were already inclined towards research because you said that you had already published a paper before joining IIM, right?
Yes.
So then when you applied for FPMs, which were the IIMs from where you got a call for the interview?
Like I applied for IIM Bangalore, Calcutta, Indore and Coimbatore, and I got a call from Calcutta, Coimbatore and Indore.
So you use your JRF score for this?
Yes, I use my JRF score, and in case of Indore, like we have RAT.
Right.
So, that was not a problem, but in case of Calcutta and Coimbatore, my JRF worked in my favor.
Okay, so before we discuss about your interview at IIM Indore, let us first talk about IIM Calcutta and Coimbatore interview. How was it and what was your experience particularly about each of the IIMs which you appeared for?
So I will start with my first interview, that was at IIM Calcutta. Mm-hmm. It was taken by the renowned Professor Ashok Banerjee, who is known for finance in IIM Calcutta. I was the first candidate, and to be honest, my interview at IIM Calcutta was not that. The reason was, like Ashok Banerjee and the other panelists were from accounting area, and my area of interest is finance. So one thing is that you should be very much clear with which area are you interested in finance or accounting, and accordingly you pitch for it.
Right.
So in IIM Calcutta, since both of the profs were from accounting area, and despite my repeated attempts to tell them that my inclination is towards finance, mm-hmm. but they asked me all the questions from accounting, which I was not prepared for, and then they asked me few questions from the research paper that I had written. Mm-hmm. So in the interviews, they might seem like it's finance, so it's going to be full of equations and some numerical portion, and they can even ask you to come on the board and write that equation.
Right. The same thing happened to me as well. I mean, they asked me to solve questions.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
So this is like maybe common for nearly all the areas.
Yeah.
So like in IIM Calcutta, we have two different departments, OB and HR for OB HR area. For finance, they have just one department for finance. No accounting and
because
finance.
Finance, accounting and control as one area.
Okay. So those who are appearing for the interview at IIM Calcutta, they can expect questions from both accounting as well as finance.
Right.
Instead of just your specialization, your interest area, right?
And once I entered the interview room, I specified that they asked me like which particular subject are you teaching, mm-hmm. and for how long. So when I told them it was for 3 semesters, mm-hmm. They didn't ask me a single question from the subjects that I were teaching.
So probably your WorkEx may not always be very helpful. Yeah, I mean they may not ask you any questions from the WorkEx. So this is something very important because generally I receive these queries ki what kind of questions can be asked with respect to my prior WorkEx, and the same thing happened to me as well because they didn't ask me anything about my army experience. So maybe the same thing applies to you. So maybe we shouldn't rely on one thing, the experience thing, and we should have a holistic or more broader view about self. And
one point to add to my mm-hmm. Calcutta interview, that they are looking for the students who have strong mathematical background.
Okay.
So in my case, they asked me the questions from statistics. So I gave the answer that I know basic statistics.
Right.
That's not a problem.
Right.
But they started asking me questions from regression.
Okay.
So what is R square, and have you ever done differentiation integration, which I did in my second year of BCom honors,
but
didn't brush it up.
Right. Absolutely.
So they are looking for students who are good at finance as well as mathematics.
Okay, so this is one thing that one should take into consideration, especially for IIM Calcutta.
Yeah.
It's known as the financial, you know, best IIM for finance as well. So what about Coimbatore? Now you are moving to...
Yeah. So second interview in IIM Coimbatore, which I was able to convert.
Okay.
And there were, I guess, 6 panelists in my interview. Mm-hmm. And they were really favoring me, whatever, like I stated that my area of interest is finance. they started asking me questions from finance area, and then they asked me a lot number of questions about from my research paper.
Okay.
So, like my research paper was on mutual funds, so they wanted to know whether I am thorough with my fundamentals about mutual funds,
right.
The nitty gritties, like in mutual funds we have a concept called total expense ratio. So they were not asking me what is the literal meaning of the
literal
term.
Meaning of the term, but at least you should know.
But like they asked me what is the present total expense ratio as per SEBI guidelines.
Okay.
So. These were the sort of questions and some basic questions on capital budgeting techniques.
Mm-hmm.
Since I told them I am teaching financial management, so there were a few questions from it. And when you say finance, then I even advise is that always prepare for portfolio theory by Harry Markowitz and the capital asset pricing model. That is going to be one point where majority of questions can be asked.
Okay, so this is one area that one should especially pressure for this.
Like if you say finance,
mm-hmm.
so they always start with the three basic decision in corporate finance.
Okay.
Then they will go to portfolio theory, and then they will ask some basic questions about the investment, how do you compute risk in return. So these basic questions will always be asked.
So in my case, the IIM Calcutta interview lasted for 2 days. So the first round and the second round, the same thing happened for you as well.
In our area, there was only one round.
Okay, only one round.
Yeah.
How many faculties were there, the interviewers?
Two.
Okay, great. Like what happened my time, we had RAT as well, apart from the
mm-hmm.
first round. So in first round, there were three faculties, then RAT, and then the second round, again, area specific. What happened in Kozhikode? Six faculties together?
Yeah, six faculties together, only one round of interview.
Okay.
And one thing that I felt good in Kozhikode was they asked me for my introduction part, so that makes
okay.
you comfortable.
Exactly.
So
right, right.
Once they started asking me questions, definitely you are going to get some cold reaction from
mm-hmm.
a few faculty members.
Right.
Like they are literally judging you, what type of answer you are saying, what is your body language.
Right.
And then there were one faculty, like since I was from DU, so he asked whether this particular prof taught you. So, you know,
okay.
That just developed
right, exactly.
a sense of belongingness. Yes, he knows
yes.
that particular faculty.
Yes, yes.
And in the end, like if they are interested in selecting you, so they will ask this question. What would be your reaction if we select you? Like, what would be your contribution to area of education? So,
okay.
I will say, like, you should try to give a balanced response to such questions as
right.
well. Like,
right.
it's not necessary that you should be thoroughly sound in the
academic portion,
but you're also looking for your prospects as becoming a faculty in future.
Okay. So, you should have a broader understanding about
right.
your career,
right.
especially what will happen in the next 5 years. So, you should be prepared for that.
For it.
Right. Now, coming to the RAT exam for IIM Indore, how did you actually start preparing for this RAT exam? What were the areas which you actually brushed up for this exam, RAT especially?
Like in our RAT, there
mm-hmm.
were three areas, starting with English,
okay.
then the research aptitude, and
right.
the third one was maths.
Okay.
So, to be honest, I literally worked on the research aptitude part because you need to understand what are the basics of hypothesis testing. Like if you are a master's student and are done with your post-graduation,
mm-hmm.
then you have some slight idea.
Right.
But its application in research matters a lot. So
right.
for that, I referred to one book, which is E.R. Kothari,
okay,
in Basic
Kothari.
Research Methods.
Okay.
And that helped me in understanding then starting with the hypothesis testing.
That thick one book, Kothari ka,
there is
Basic Statistics.
Basic Statistics, but it was not one. It's
okay.
the it's written for the Indian audience.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
I had the same thing. Maybe probably you referred to a precise,
concise
version of that.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, I referred this book. It's really good. You should go for it, especially if you want to get a basic idea
mm-hmm.
about statistics,
right.
not
right.
a very detailed. So those who are in the undergrads, normally they refer to this book.
Mm-hmm.
And for Indians, especially Indian students, this would be very helpful because the language is easy.
Easy. Right.
Yeah.
And they're not going to talk about basic mean, mode, mean.
Yeah, yeah.
They will start with the
hypothesis
testing, then your design method, scaling
right.
techniques.
Right.
So that will give you a brief idea.
Brief idea, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
So can you tell me how many questions were there in this RAT examination?
There were 90 questions
okay.
in RAT 2018.
18.
And 30 questions in each section.
Okay.
So one advice is that try to attempt balanced number of questions in every section.
Okay.
It's not like you're good in English, so you're attempting all 30.
Right.
Since
right.
there is a component of negative marking, so you might end up losing marks
okay.
due to over attempt in one area. And right. like regarding the maths, there were 30 questions and mm-hmm. it was a bit difficult for me to attend the maths section, but I made sure mm-hmm. that I was able to attend 15 questions out of 30.
Okay, 15 from each section.
Yeah, but overall I attempted 59 questions out of 90 questions.
Okay.
And the ones where I was confident, mm-hmm. I was attempting in maths, because mm-hmm. Maths is one thing where you know your answer is right or wrong.
There right,
is
right, no exactly. way between. Yeah, yeah, true.
And mm-hmm. similarly for the research aptitude, you just don't try to bluff.
Okay, right.
So that will not work in your favor. Mm-hmm. In that case, English went well, then research aptitude again, I was able to right. answer 15-20 questions. Mm-hmm. And in maths, I still remember I attempted only 15.
So on an average, we are expected to attempt at least 60% of the
yeah,
questions.
60%.
Yeah, so that even if we lose some marks due to mm-hmm. negative marking, we should land up at least up to
right.
55 to 59%, right?
Right?
So that would be sufficient to get a call.
Yeah.
And but may not be very sufficient to finally get into the merit list through
yeah.
on a merit list. So maybe for selection, for RAT selection, this would be sufficient.
For RAT selection, it is sufficient, and mm-hmm. since our merit list is prepared on the basis of weighted average
yeah, weighted
interview
average.
And RAT,
right, right.
So your performance in interview will matter. But like in, I still remember in our area, some 25 to 30 people were called in finance.
Okay. Finance. 30 people.
30 people. Once they were once they qualified RAT.
Right.
And then coming to the interview part, mm-hmm. They were taking so much time with the initial 5 candidates. So,
okay.
Like I was not among the first 5.
Right.
So you start getting inputs from your friends, like what type of questions are they asking.
Mm-hmm.
So those interviews lasted for 45 minutes for one participant.
Okay.
And in my case, it just lasted for 20 minutes.
Okay, that's great. And still you
yeah.
were able to...
So you cannot say like my interview lasted for 50 minutes.
Right,
I will
right.
be surely selected in this
yes.
IIM. That
yes.
is not guarantee.
Yes.
My interview lasted for 20 minutes. They didn't start with my introduction, so mm-hmm. that made me a bit nervous. They're not simply asking,
yeah.
and there were 3 panelists
uh-huh.
in my interview.
Mm-hmm.
Two were one from finance area,
okay.
one from accounting area, and one was from economics area.
So there will be 2 faculties from
your
own
area,
and the third faculty may be from a related
areas
like
right.
economics and all.
Right.
And Garima, can you tell me one thing? When you were sitting for the interview, so you were expecting to, you know, enter the interview room. So many participants, they actually asked me the question, like there are many people surrounding me and they ask me a lot of questions.
Mm-hmm.
And some of them are even professors currently working as a professor, yet they get a call and everybody expect that.